Section 1 of Readings and Poetry for Lent, Ash Wednesday by Sir Archibald Edmonstone. Mourn ye o'er the nation's sin, mourn his temple courts within. Priests and people, own the rod, weeping, bow before your God. Queen of waters, veil thy pride, boast not of thy commerce wide, that the sun doth never set on thy jeweled coronet. Boast not that thine ensigns tower, boast not that thy foemen cower. Mourn and weep that thou canst bring to pure incense to thy king. All thy treasured gold is dross, all thy store is empty loss. Mammon reigns where God should dwell, as fiends haunt the hermit's cell. Church, our mother, fast and pray, if thou judgment may delay. Princes, priests, and people all, low before his footstool fall. Lenten time will soon pass by, catch the moments as they fly. Fasting, praying, draw ye near, he is present, he will hear. End of section 1.
Section 2 of Readings and Poetry for Lent, Sunday of Lent. Matthew, chapter 4, verses 1 through 11. Then was Jesus led up of the Spirit into the wilderness to be tempted of the devil. And when he had fasted 40 days and 40 nights, he was afterward an hungered. And when the tempter came to him, he said, If thou be the Son of God, command that these stones be made bread. But he answered and said, It is written, Man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceedeth out of the mouth of God. Then the devil taketh him up into the holy city, and sitteth him on a pinnacle of the temple, and saith unto him, If thou be the Son of God, cast thyself down, for it is written, He shall give his angels charge concerning thee. And in their hands they shall bear thee up, lest at any time thou dash thy foot against a stone. Jesus said unto him, It is written again, Thou shalt not tempt the Lord thy God. Again the devil taketh him up into an exceeding high mountain, and showeth him all the kingdoms of the world, and the glory of them, and saith unto him, All these things will I give thee, if thou wilt fall down and worship me. Then saith Jesus unto him, Get thee hence, Satan, for it is written, Thou shalt worship the Lord thy God, and him only shalt thou serve. Then the devil leaveth him, and behold, angels came and ministered unto him. Those who, in obedience to the rules of their church, have resolved to make Lent a season of retirement and of spiritual improvement, a season when they will especially endeavor to mortify the lusts of the flesh and advance in their spiritual course, will find that they have entered upon a difficult work. They have voluntarily engaged to be, in an especial manner, during this period, the Lord's soldiers, and to fight against sin, the world, and the devil. And Satan, who is ever on the lookout, will take care their promise shall not be an idle one. He will give them plenty to do. Just at first it seems an easy thing to perform the pledge which we have taken. We have made a solemn resolution before God that you will resist your besetting sin, whatever it may be, and you are thinking that you will not once give way to it during the next 6 weeks, and are already imagining how pleasant it will be at Easter to look back upon your victory. But depend upon it, your task will not be thus lightly accomplished. Your great enemy will not be thus defeated. He will try by every means in his power to make you fall, and wonderful will it be if he does not succeed. If he cannot manage it one way, he will try another, and will tempt you by means which you have never thought of, and against which, therefore, you have never guarded. But be not discouraged, and above all, never think of giving up the contest. He would be a poor soldier who retreated because the enemy attacked him, and a feeble runner who gave up because his course was not all smooth. Ever remember that it is not in your own strength that the warfare is to be carried out, though your Savior may seem to abandon.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.